Mateo, so you can take off your mic. You can only take this one, okay? And then wipe it.
Yeah, it's better. Better suited to my head, I guess.
Just try to see if that'd be close, just because then you can't hear anything.
Okay. Hi, everyone. Thank you for coming together today to commemorate the remarkable impact that Haley Takeda has left on each and every one of us. I've known Haley since my freshman year of high school, and we've spent a lot of time together. During that time together, I've realized that Haley has the purest heart and soul that I may ever witness. She was so involved. But even more so, she was curious. She loved learning new things, trying new things, and bringing people together as she did. She would be the reason that we went and explored a new hiking trail or a new part of the city. And she was the one who would always take photos, capturing each new memory with the click of a button. I was never really one who enjoyed taking photos, but now I treasure every snapshot that we have together. She was the person who I would call whenever I was stressed out or needed advice, and that's because she was always so understanding and she knew exactly what to say. Her brightness was so radiant that she helped others shine too, and I see that now more than ever. In the last week, so many people have shared stories with me about how Haley shared her light with them, whether it be through inspiration, motivation, or being there when other people needed her. I could give you a specific story about a concert that we went to or a trip that we went on, but honestly, the largest impact that Haley had on me was in our day-to-day lives, always talking on FaceTime or going on runs, going to new restaurants in our area. I just knew that I had someone who would be there for me, regardless of what obstacles may lay ahead. And that's the light that Haley shared with me. Her support and positive driven attitude has helped me shine brighter. She was a best friend that I could count on no matter what, and someone who I would do anything for. And so I'd like to share a poem with you. This is called Gone From My Sight. I'm standing upon the seashore. A ship at my side spreads her white sails to the morning breeze and starts for the blue ocean. She is an object of beauty and strength. I stand and watch her until at length she hangs like a speck of white cloud where the sea and sky come to mingle with each other. Then someone at my side says, "There, she's gone." "Gone where?" "Gone from my sight, that is all. She is just as large in mass and hull and spar as she was when she left my side. She is just as able to bear her load of living freight to her destined port. Her diminished size is in me, not her. And just at the moment when someone says at my side, "There, she is gone," there are other eyes watching her coming and other voices ready to take up the glad shout, "Here she comes." Thank you. Now, Bella and Grace, if you could come up, that'd be awesome.
you dream of once in a lullaby. Hi, someday I'll wish upon a star. Wake up where the clouds are far behind me, where trouble melts like lemon drops. High above the chimney tops, that's where you'll find me. Oh, somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly, and the dreams that you dare to, oh, why can't I?
Thank you, I'm a little tall. Does this work for everyone? Is everyone okay if I take my mask off? Is that okay? Sorry, I'm already crying. Before I got here, I had prepared something, but I kind of just want to speak from where I'm at now. After seeing everyone here who loved Haley just as much as I do, for me, it's the small moments I'm gonna miss the most. Of course, like, don't get me wrong, the first days of school and our high school dances were memories I would not trade for the world. But it's memories like me going to her house for the first time and her bird pooping on my head and us just laughing so hard that I'm gonna miss the most. And that laugh, man, like, I wish I could hear it again. I was looking through old photos on my phone when I heard, I was looking through old photos and her smile made me smile, and I could just feel the joy that she radiated for each and every one of us. And she was truly just, we are not gonna meet another Haley Takeda in this world ever, ever. She was so funny and so kind and just so compassionate and goofy. And she was also so complex and smart, beautiful inside and out. And knowing Haley, I know, you know, this is a very sad, very unfortunate, upsetting situation, but knowing Haley, she would want us to focus on all the good times we had. She would want us to remember all the smiles and laughs we shared, all the songs we sang together, all the dances we've danced. And we danced, let me tell you. And I just feel so fortunate to have gotten to grow up with someone so rare and genuine. Someone that I wish I had reached out to more after college. Because I loved her and I knew she loved me and I knew she loved everyone here. And she loved fully. She did not love with half her heart. She loved with her whole heart and then some. Sorry. And I wish I could hug her for one last time. Because she was one of those people that can make anyone and everyone feel special. Everyone feel heard. Everyone feel seen. And everyone feel loved. And that is just so rare to find in a person. It's so rare. And I have learned so much growing up with her. I knew her when she had bangs in elementary school. And, you know, I knew her up until the last moment. And I just learned so much. And I continue to learn so much from her. You know, she was a person that spread joy just 'cause. She never expected anything. And I want to honor her by spreading that same joy, as I think we all should. She was a person that lived life to the fullest and took risks. And we should all take risks, just like Haley. She was a person that I consider to be family, because friends are my chosen family. And it is just so hard knowing someone I love so much is gone. But a group of us were talking on FaceTime the other day, and it brings me some comfort. I think it was Grace who brought it up. With friends and family, we each exchange parts of each other. And those parts you will never lose. It's like a puzzle piece. And it gives me so much comfort knowing that I'll always have a part of Haley with me. And Haley will always have a part of me with her. And I really, really hope that she... I know she's somewhere beautiful. And she's making that place way more beautiful. Let's be honest. And I don't really know what I quite believe in. But I was out in nature and went to a crystal shop and I found some crystals that would hopefully help her pass into wherever she was going. She doesn't need help though because she was just the best and there's no words that can do her justice. So I'm gonna leave you all with just a challenge to live like Haley. Give a stranger a compliment. Reach out to the friends you miss. Make sure you remind everyone that you love them, because that's what she did. So just live like Haley, because she deserves the world and more. Thank you so much.
Do my best here. Hopefully that's better.
So I was thinking a lot, and if I could use one word to describe Haley, it would be magnetic. She was magnetizing. And I think it's evident by, you know, I look at social media, I look at all the people here, how many people shared their stories of how Haley affected them in a big or a small way. And that just shows, like, how good she was at bringing people together. And for me, in high school, I was pretty introverted in the beginning. And she helped me bring me out of my shell. And to that, I think, being the reason why I'm friends with a lot of people in this crowd. You know, without her, I might have not even been as close with a lot of you. And she just instilled this sense of confidence with me and helped me do things I never would have thought I would have been able to do. Like, I never would have thought in my senior year I would have been standing there in the great court with a boombox on my shoulder in front of everyone with my bad dance moves asking her to senior prom. And she always made sure, you know, she always made sure I was invited and I was there. And sometimes I'd be like, I don't really know if I want to go out today. And the next text would be, I'm outside. And you can't say no to that. And I was lucky enough to still be close to her after we graduated. And she was almost a role model for me. And in the way that, you know, she was so put together, but still didn't take herself too seriously. And she was so driven in all of the projects that we did. And I just looked up to her and wanted to be around her. And, you know, everyone feels the same. And I think from my experience, Haley just brings out the best in people. And I think that's what made her so magnetic. And honestly, I kind of took it for granted. And now all I want to do is just treasure what she brought to me, what she brought to all my friends, what she brought to this community. And I just want to make her proud. Thank you.
Okay. I'm sorry. I had the pleasure of being Haley's dance teacher during her high school years at Hillsdale. From the moment she walked into my room, I knew immediately that she was something different. Her ability to light up a room and a stage and make it her own was unparalleled. And it puts my heart at ease to know those years we shared were filled with so much love and passion for our art. During those years and after, the lives that Haley touched were more than fellow dance ensembles or students of mine. We became a family. We shared unforgettable long hours together, laughing, crying, growing, loving, and doing what we do the best, dancing. I had the pleasure of reconnecting with so many alumni who knew Haley well, and some who didn't know her at all, but knew that our ensemble family connected us in the same way. With each conversation, it was clear that we all agreed that the best way to honor Haley would be through the beautiful art that brought us together, at least until we could meet again for our encore performance. 3 years ago, we celebrated our 20th year of Night Moves, and recreated some original works that had been performed in the past. One of the last pieces that Haley performed was a trio called Read All About It, choreographed by alumni Sean Carino. Here to perform for you Read All About It, alumni Robbie Button and Nella Biox.
Thank you. Hello everyone. For those who don't know me, my name is Jessica. And I was lucky enough to call Haley one of my best friends during high school.
It's hard to find the right words to express how incredible Haley was. There are so many memories I could share with her, like going to our first high school parties together, having her be my Spanish class buddy, taking a weekend girls trip to the beach, or just sitting and eating lunch by the pool every single day of high school. But besides all of the memories, I think it's important to share how she made her friends feel and all of the positive energy she radiated into the world. I remember when Haley and her family moved down the street from my house, and I went over to chat with her about her trip to the Dominican Republic and help unpack her new room. After hearing about her trip, I was in awe of how easily she was able to make connections with people literally across the globe. And I could listen to her talk for hours about how passionate she was about the experience she had there. That's something that I'll never forget about Haley, and I know no one else will. She can make friends with anyone basically instantly because she was the most kind and outgoing person whose energy lifted up the spirits of those around her. She was there for us when we needed her comfort and can turn around and make us laugh with her goofiness. I've never met someone who was constantly so energetic, bright, and I will carry a piece of her light with me for the rest of my life, as will all of those who knew her. I would like to share a poem that comes from the Jewish morning prayer book that I think encapsulates the idea that although Haley isn't with us anymore, I know her spirit lives with all of us and her love will continue to be spread for years to come. When I die, give what's left of me away to children and old men that wait to die. And if you need to cry, cry for your brother walking the street beside you. And when you need me, put your arms around anyone and give them what you need to give me. I want to leave you something, something better than words or sounds. Look for me in the people I've known or loved. And if you cannot give me away, at least let me live in your eyes and not in your mind. You can love me most by letting hands touch hands, by letting bodies touch bodies, and by letting go of children that need to be free. Love doesn't die, people do. So when all that's left of me is love, give me away. Haley, we will continue to give your love to the world. I love you and will miss you, and I cherish the memories we made and will remember how warm you made me feel for the rest of my life. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. For those of you who don't know me, I am Sophia. I went to middle school and high school with Haley. Haley was my best and longest friend. Since sixth grade, every waking moment, she was by my side, from countless nights rehearsing for Abbott Middle School plays, to sewing lessons during our school breaks, to summers at Gate theater camps, to being the only two freshmen on Hillsdale's dance ensemble, to having almost every class together, and to eating lunch on the pool stairs every day for 4 years. Our lives were truly intertwined. The other day, I was watching our senior year Night Moves production. At the very end, all the seniors get to do a final goodbye dance. As one of the 4 years, Haley got to do a solo, and I remember I watched as she ran onto center stage and the music crescendoed and the lights changed and she lit up the entire auditorium with her presence. That's just Haley, big, bright, and full of energy. She knew how to turn anything into an unforgettable memory. She had these grand ideas for new fun things to do. When we were 12, she taught me the entire dance to burlesque, and we performed it in the front yard of one of my friends, and we had full-on matching costumes, and we even filmed a music video to the song. I know. She would be the one to plan a weekend trip to LA where we'd go to Disneyland, visit the Santa Monica Pier, run into the oceans in the middle of the night. She remembered to document everything and take hundreds of pictures. So in times like these, we can always look back on something and remember that exact moment. For Haley, the sky was the limit. Any goal she had, she achieved. She was my favorite person to pick for group projects because she was the only other person that I knew who was just as over the top as me. No one else would be willing to pull three all-nighters to film a full-on movie production quality trailer to Macbeth. No one else would spend countless hours intricately painting a board game for our history class that barely even counted for a grade. Haley was so smart and so creative. She really pushed me to reach my full potential. I admired her ambition and how she gave everything in her life 110%, not just with academics or hobbies, but also with her relationships with others. From being in the same friend groups, I witnessed how she would always extend invitations to everyone. She wanted every single person to feel included and to be part of these memories. From being in dance ensemble together for 4 years, I witnessed how she would always lend a helping hand to everyone on the team. She took so many people under her wing and made them feel so welcome and part of our community. She was a role model, hardworking, talented, yet humble. Haley touched every single person who was in her life. I will never forget all these beautiful memories we shared. I miss you so much, Haley. Your presence and your magnetic energy will remain inside all of our hearts forever. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everybody. Everybody, can you hear me okay? Thank you. For those who don't know me, my name is James. I had the amazing experience of being able to meet Haley, and we went out for my last couple years at Hillsdale, and when I was in college, we stayed together for a while. Stuck through me through college, and I remember one of the last gifts she gave me, I put it in my video. It was a quote that I think speaks to her and who she was so perfectly. It's from the Broadway musical, Wicked. The quote is, "Whatever way our stories end, you will have rewritten mine by being my friend." And Haley will forever have rewritten my story. Taught me so much about myself. And when I moved to Hawaii, 3,000 miles across the water, great idea, I used to send her a song every night, not every night, but when I could. This was this song. It's called Lullaby. Missing your face and your touch, missing your kiss and your love, missing every little bit and piece of you. Baby, won't you meet me halfway, cause I'm down for you. Ooh, and the many things that I would do just to feel you. you and hold you. Man, it's so hard not to have you here. You're probably sitting like me, missing you, baby. Ooh-wee. A promise to listen before you sleep. When you're staring at the stars, looking at the moon, wishing that I could be there with you. It's okay and it's alright. Baby, listen to this lullaby. Good night, sleep tight. And dream away with me tonight. Yeah, we can sit on the phone, bussing all night until the early morning. It's still not the same, cause you're far away. Hearing your voice, I've got no choice. It's the only way that makes me feel closer. I guess until then, just listen. When you're staring at the stars, looking at the moon, wishing that I could be there with you. It's okay and it's alright. Baby, listen to this lullaby. Good night, sleep tight. And dream away with me tonight. Wherever you are, no matter how far, just listen for me, I'll sing you to sleep. I love you, good night, and dream away with me tonight, and dream away with me tonight. Thank you.
Thank you so much for inviting me to honor Haley in this way tonight. My name is Pastor Karen Thistlethwaite, and it is an honor and a privilege to be here. Before I get started, I want you to take a moment, just look around the person to your left and to your right. They have a little bit of Haley, maybe a lot of Haley, inside each one of them. And so if you want to remember, if you want to celebrate, if you want to mourn, there is someone here to do that with, and someone out there as well. My family and I, we live just beyond those trees, and while not at the same time, I went to Meadow Heights and spent time in the library with Mrs. Wells, who's my mom, and then continued on to Abbott Middle School. As you have heard tonight, Haley was someone who was passionate. She was loving and caring and expressive. One of my good friends texted me and said, Haley was someone who was kind and attentive and really focused on you when you were with her. She said she was a true role model for her daughter, and I know that means a lot. Had the depth to sit with friends in their sorrows, and someone who is eager to celebrate in times of joy. Psalm 23 describes God in much the same way, stating, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me on paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me and the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. In this passage, God is lovingly described as a shepherd, guiding us, restoring us, comforting us, walking with us in our sorrow, and preparing a place for us, filling us up with more goodness and mercy than we ever knew possible. This passage describes God guiding Haley, restoring her, comforting her, walking with her, and preparing a place for her, and filling Haley up with more goodness and mercy than she ever knew possible. And that's saying a lot. Someone once told me that it is because we love so deeply that when someone is taken from us, our heart breaks in ways that we never knew possible. There will be times, perhaps you're feeling it right now, that this pain will feel overwhelming, and the pain is all that you can see. It may feel like the brokenness is taking over your whole body, and you don't have the words to express how you feel. And that is okay. For that pain is a reminder that you have loved, and that you have loved deeply. And as Haley would probably be the first to tell us, isn't that what dance is all about? About expressing ideas and emotions that we can't quite put into words. Or perhaps this expression of the unexpressible happens for you while you are running, or drawing, or singing, or writing, or simply being still. We don't have to answer all the questions. Often it is just enough to stop and wrestle with the questions themselves, to admit that we don't know, that we might not ever know, and to hold on tightly to the things that we love the most about Haley. In Romans 8, the Apostle Paul, someone who also had a lot of questions and struggles in his life, describes his relationship with God like this. And who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble or hardship or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword? No. In all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels nor demons, nor the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. This scripture fearlessly proclaims that God loves us and God has chosen us, that God loves Haley and has chosen Haley. Therefore, nothing, absolutely nothing, can tear us or Haley apart from God's love. And nothing can tear us apart from the love that we have for Haley or that she has for us. In seeking to honor Haley and the place that she holds in our hearts, I invite you to respond to the following sentiments with "We remember you." And because of COVID and because Haley was a dancer, I invite you to use your heart and movement to say these words out loud. Going, "We remember you." Let's all try that. "We remember you." If you're watching online, I invite you to join us as well, knowing that no space can separate our connections from each other. Haley, in knowing that you are returning home to the place you were created, please join me. "We remember you." Haley, in knowing that in our struggles and in our conflicts, we all have received God's forgiveness and love, "We remember you." Haley, in knowing that your days were filled with passion, energy, and excitement, we remember you. Haley, in knowing that you are held safe in God's hands, we remember you. And Haley, most of all, in knowing that you have all our love, we remember you. Amen.
Everyone, wanted to thank everyone for coming and everyone who is watching the live stream. And a big thank you to everyone who helped put this event together. It is really beautiful getting to see our community come together and honor Haley in such a beautiful way. I wanted to give a few instructions. After the closing prayer, Amy and Lauren will be handing out tea light candles, and you are all welcome to join us for a walking visual to Hillsdale, the outside the dance room. We'll be walking right after. We will just hang out for a few minutes. We will be just cleaning up, putting everything away, and then we'll all be walking down 28th towards Alameda. Then down Alameda, then up 31st to the Hillsdale Dance Room where you can place your tea light candles. So yes, thank you.
I now invite you to join me in prayer in whichever way is authentic for you. Lord of life and death, you made us in your image and hold us in your care. We thank you for your daughter Haley and the gift of her life and for the love and mercy she received from you and gave to us. Lord, we especially praise you for the love you have given us in God, and we know that Haley will arrive safely into your hands. May she know your never failing care and love as she dwells in your presence forevermore. Amen. Love knows no bounds, no limits. And now may you go tonight knowing that you are loved. May you go tonight knowing that we have all loved Haley so much and that absolutely nothing can separate us from the love that we have for Haley or the love that she has for us. Blessings and peace upon you. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you.